So chemical kinetics under the heading of electrochemistry and chemical kinetics. So chemical kinetics. So the father of chemical kinetics is Wilhelm. He is a father of chemical kinetics. And next one. In chemistry, there are so many reactions are there. In that, some of the reactions are fast, some reactions are slow, or some reactions are moderate. In this, for example, ionic reactions are there. In these ionic reactions are very fast reactions, or the rusting, okay, or roasting, or rusting. The rusting of iron takes more time. So means this is a very slow process. In that slow process, the determination, the what are the changes are observed. So the detect is very difficult. Due to that, the chemical kinetics, in that chemical kinetics, it is belongs to physical chemistry branch. In this process, we can determine rate of reaction. We can determine rate of reaction under the heading of, under the heading of pressure, comma temperature, and concentration. Pressure, temperature, concentration is called as chemical kinetics. Means the rate of reaction is detected under the heading of pressure, temperature, concentration, and time is called as chemical kinetics. So in that we are heading, again we are discuss some important terms which are involved in chemical kinetics. So in that, first one is rate of reaction. Rate of reaction. Okay. The rate of reaction means the changing of concentration. The changing of concentration in a reaction, in a chemical reaction, is called as rate of reaction, or changing of, or changing means you are decreasing. The changing of concentration of a reaction in a chemical reaction is called as rate of reaction, or changing means here, first one you have discussed, decreasing. Okay. So decreasing of concentration of reactant, or decreasing of concentration of reactant, or increasing of concentration of product is called as rate of reaction. Means generally the rate of reaction is denoted with R. So its mathematical equation is R equal to dx by dt. Means the decreasing of concentration of reactant with time, or increasing of concentration of product with time, is called as rate of reaction, or the changing of concentration in a chemical reaction is called as rate of reaction. So means its mathematical equation is R equal to dx by dt. Means here R is equal to the changing of concentration. The changing of concentration by per unit time. R equal to decreasing. Decreasing of concentration of reactant by per unit time, or increasing of concentration of product per unit time means increasing of time. So increasing of time, its concentration of product is increases, but a reactant concentration is decreases with time. So means while you are writing of mathematical equation for this equation, what happened? A reactant means dx by dt. So So changing of concentration, but a decreasing means you are denoted with minus, or you are increasing. So the concentration of product is increases. Again same equation, dx by dt, but your sign is different. Your sign is plus. Your plus indicates increasing, minus means decreasing. So means here all your minus indicates that negative sign. That negative sign only for decreasing of concentration, but the concentration value is not minus. Okay, here concentration of the product is increases with time. So whenever the graph is plotted in between, on x axis we are considered time, on y axis we are considered concentration. So only two factors. One factor is time on x axis, concentration on y axis. In that, you have two processes. If the whenever the decreasing of concentration, so decreasing of concentration of reactant, we are represented like this. This is your decreasing. The increasing of product, that is represented like this. So means this is your increasing of concentration of product. The second curve means here we denoted this is your first curve, this is your second curve. The first curve is applicable for decreasing of concentration of reactant. Second curve is applicable for increasing of concentration of product. So this is your rate of reaction. Okay. And second term, in this chemical kinetics, we discuss another new term, that is second one is rate constant. Rate constant. Rate constant means, for example, simple example, A is converted to product. So A is the reactant, that reactant is converted to a one product. So in that, the rate means the rate is denoted with R. The R is directly proportional to concentration of A, means the reactant, the concentration of reactant. So that is the removing of this proportionality constant, we are getting K, that concentration of reactant. Okay. So means there the rate of constant value is unity. So means R equal to K. This is your first example. If you consider second example, A plus B is converted to product. In that the rate is directly proportional to concentration of reactant A into B, concentration of A into concentration of B. In this, while removing of this proportionality constant, again we are getting K into concentration of A into concentration of B. In this process, the reactant concentration is considered as unity. Again what happened? R equal to K. So this is rate constant, means the rate constant is equals to rate of reaction in a chemical reaction is called as rate constant, means the rate constant is always equals to rate of reaction. Okay, so the rate unit, the units of rate is mole per liter per time. This is the unit for rate constant. In this process, after the completion of rate constant, so means the concentration, so another term, third one is rate law. Okay. The rate is directly proportional to concentration of reactant. Means the rate of reaction is directly proportional to concentration is called as rate law. And fourth one is, we discuss very important term, this is order of reaction. Order of reaction. Okay. In this also we have discussed very simple example, again same, the A is converted to product. So A is the reactant, that reactant is converted to product. But the order of reaction and the rate constant, both are different terms. See here, we already discussed, rate is directly proportional to concentration of reactant. Here A is the reactant, means R is proportional to concentration of A. Okay. On the concentration, here the power is unity, that is 1. So means R is equals to, so the while removing of proportionality constant, we are getting K1 into concentration of A. Means this is which order? This total rate of reaction is depends on one unit term. So one unit, that is called as first order reaction. This is your K1, means first order reaction. Therefore, this is your first order reaction. Or if you consider another example, A plus B is converted to product. In this process, the rate is directly proportional to concentration of A and concentration of B, means reactant. Here the reactants are 2, thus the powers are, the reactant power is 1 mole, here also 1 unit. So that while removing of proportionality constant, we are getting K, that is your constant value, that is concentration of power unit and concentration of B. Here total concentration is depends on 2, means your K value is how much? 2. 2 means this was second order reaction. Here K value is how much? 1. So if whenever the K value is 1, that is your first order reaction. Here K value is 2, this is your second order reaction.